9/11 Film Festival here in Oakland. So it's going on. It went on, started last night. Dylan Avery came and showed, it was the world premiere of the next version of Loose Change. After the final cut is a new one called Loose Change 9/11 American Coup. So we saw that last night. And then there are films running all day today, some excellent films, including, by the way, the Anthrax Wars. And then I speak tonight. And yes, there are events all over the country today. So the 9/11 issue is definitely not going to go away.
You mentioned before the break the critiques which were waged against you. And I recall as well, and it bothered me significantly that several of your critics are in fact people who claim to be progressive and who are themselves anti-war researchers as well as critics of U.S. foreign policy. I won't mention names, but could you perhaps tell us a little bit about that? Because it's bothersome that the 9/11 truth movement hasn't been absorbed and embraced by the anti-war movement.
Yes, it is very disappointing because, the 9/11 movement is an anti-war movement. We're pointing out that the pretext for the war in Iraq and the war in Afghanistan was 9/11, as well as the pretext for the great elimination of human rights, the extraordinary extradition, and so on. It all goes back to 9/11. And yet so many people on the left want to distance themselves from us, and in doing so, not only don't join us, but attack us more viciously than the mainstream press does in order to prove that they're not 9/11 nuts. Now, these people are either, I think they are just ignorant. They are so certain they're right, or they're so certain that they don't dare have anything to do with this, that they will not study the facts. I was just in conversation with a fellow, and he just kept giving me a priori reasons. Well, why would they do this? Why they wouldn't have done this? And I said, well, look, we can't sit here and figure out why and what they would have done and so on. The important thing is the empirical facts, and the empirical fact is, and I listed a few of these, he won't even look at them. So he just wants to stay with his belief, and, he's an anti-imperialist, but he will not use this as one of the reasons to criticize the present version of the American empire, and yet that's precisely what the expansion has been based on.
I think that we have to go to a short commercial break. Our guest, David Ray Griffin, and Jacques Marcil from the... Welcome back to the Global Research News Hour. This is Michel Shostakovsky. Our program, which is broadcast Monday through Friday, is an initiative of the Center for Research on Globalization. Stephen Lenman will be talking to Bob Chapman tomorrow. Our guest today, David Ray Griffin, and joining us also from Montreal, Jacques Marcil, who is a representative of the 9/11 Truth Movement. Jacques, I wanted to ask you a question. There is in Canada a strong movement directed against the war in Afghanistan, and but the link with 9/11 is rarely mentioned, the fact that 9/11 was the justification for invading and occupying Afghanistan. How do you react?
Well, the anti-war movement is very strong in Quebec, probably because Quebec was invaded by the British Army over 200 years ago, and this has left an indelible mark on the collective psyche. So the Quebec population was immediately against the sending of Canadian and Quebec troops to Afghanistan, and I believe the percentage of the population that is opposed to this war in Quebec is presently around 70%, which is the vast majority of the population. Now, I think the general population understood immediately that 9/11 was used as a pretext in order to invade this country, and probably can generalize to the other invasions, the invasion of Iraq and the now invasion of Pakistan in the same way. So people can come to their own conclusions, even though they are subject to mainstream media.
But if they had a better understanding of 9/11 and if they had read through David Ray Griffin's writings, presumably it wouldn't be 70% of public opinion which would be against the war, but I would say probably everybody, because it's so grotesque. If I recall, the war on Afghanistan was declared by NATO, invoking their Article 5 of their Articles of Agreement, that it was invoked within 24 hours of the 9/11 attacks, in other words, on the following morning.
I agree entirely with you. If, for instance, the conclusion of David Ray Griffin's research were available to the public on the mass media, people would accept that 9/11 had not been instigated by an obscure group of Arab militants, and as a consequence, the opposition to the war would be far greater. As well, I think they would understand that there are other consequences, and that they themselves are actually being attacked in their own at the level of their rights and of their assets. And I would like to add as well that I think one of the reasons the anti-war movement distances itself from the 9/11 truthers is because of all the ridicule and the tar and feathering that is going on vis-a-vis the members of the 9/11 truth movement, because we are attacking the system at its Achilles heel, really.
Absolutely. David, last year you released a very important book, which was entitled 9/11 Contradictions, An Open Letter to Congress and the Press, in which you list, in each of the sections, you list a number of contradictions to the official story. My first question is, one, did you get an answer from the members of Congress? Did they ever, well, it was an open letter, but did you get any response from the U.S. Congress on these contradictions?
No, and one reason for writing this book was I know that people, both in politics and in the media, are nervous, as an understatement, to deal with conspiracy theory. Of course, you know, they won't call the main, the official story a conspiracy theory. They just use it one-sidedly for us. But that's the way the term is used. So they don't dare show the slightest bit of sympathy for a, quote, conspiracy theory, or they get labeled as a kook and lose their credibility. So in this book, I don't have any theory. So there's no conspiracy theory. There's no argument. There's just laying out 25 facts in, you know, that, say, Norman Mineta says this, Dick Cheney says this, or Richard Clark said this, and General Myers said this. And these were big things, like, where were they that morning? And so they were just facts that could be reported without any endorsement of any theory, and yet not a single member of Congress, we sent it to almost all members of Congress, not a single member did anything about it. Only three of them even acknowledged, gave thanks, you know, had secretaries give thanks for sending the book. And not a single person in the press reported on the book in the mainstream press or picked up any of the contradictions. But I've done their work for them, and yet they won't use it.
Are we not living in some kind